Welcome back to my channel. It's your girl Raya J, and I'm back with another video. Today is Monday, my babies, and I hope all is well with you all. All is well with me, and I hope we all are continuing to stay about happiness, peace, and love. And I hope we all are continuing to stay determined, motivated, and focused. And I hope we all are continuing to walk in the alignment of stars that Allah has for us. So in today's video, but before I get started, I just want to take a minute and say that Raya J, I am so proud of you continuing to push and strive and thrive, and you've been uploading every day of the month of May thus far, and I'm just so proud of you. You know, keep up the hard work, keep believing in yourself, loving yourself unconditionally, supporting yourself, and, you know, just continuing to inspire others and motivate others, and, you know, stay on these bitches' necks. Nah, just joking. I'm too humble for, you know, that kind of energy. I just stay in my lane and do what feels right to me and follow my positive and loving, peaceful energy, and, you know, and just going after life opportunities that this life has for me and that Allah has for me, you know. So yeah, inshallah, amen. You know, let's just take a moment to appreciate the hard work that your girl has been putting in thus far on the channel. And you know, maybe this is the month, my babies. It's looking like this is the month, you know, where I will be posting every day of the month of May, because I literally vow to myself, like, okay, the year of 2019, I'm finna go harder and I'm finna push myself, but I have to post every day of one of these months of the year, because that's what I want to do. You know, I want to continue to grow my channel and to be real, raw, and authentic, and, you know, continue to, you know, talk about health and safety and efficiency and truth and fun, you feel me? Because that's what Raya J's reality is all about. So let's get into today's video, which is a very serious topic. Today we are going to be discussing the situation that happened. Everything transpired 2 weeks ago, and then more events happened following up this previous week that just passed. So, you know, we're going to be discussing the death of the 3-year-old girl who was burned alive inside of a car in Queens, New York, and the inside of the car chained, and gasoline containers and stuff left inside of the vehicle when the FDNY and NYPD arrived on the scene. So, you know, y'all already know how I feel about children, pregnancy, teen pregnancies, and, you know, I just care so much about our youth and the children of this world that are being born into this world. They don't ask to be here, and, you know, they're born into, you know, whatever family they're born into, and they have to, you know, deal with their family's drama and, you know, trauma and situations and, you know, living circumstances, and, you know, they just have to deal with their life. You know, and being born into this world so innocent, you know, so loving, so trusting, and, you know, so innocent, you know, honestly. And this situation really, really broke my heart, because that little girl didn't deserve to lose her life the way that she lost her life. And not only that, but, you know, I know that her soul and, you know, her afterlife is beautiful at this point, and she is living a beautiful afterlife with Allah, because, you know, Allah really is the end all be all for us, my babies, whether you believe it or not. But regardless of what happens here on this physical life, there is something called an afterlife, and either you are going to heaven, where you will live the most beautiful, peaceful, loving, carefree life that you have ever lived, or you will go to hell and you will burn, and, you know, there will be no way out. So, you know, I know that her spirit is thriving and she is just at peace, and, you know, she is okay at this point, you know, to be put out of misery and to be put out of pain, and, you know, just to be carefree, you know. So what basically happened is 2 weeks ago in Queens, you know, the NYPD and the FDNY was called to a burning car, and I think it was Long Island, Queens. And when they got to the scene, the first of all, when they got to the scene, they tried to open the car door and the car door wouldn't open. When they bust open the door, you know, or however they did that, they found a dead 3-year-old girl in the back seat of the car. Clearly she was burned to death, and the reason why they had troubles opening the door was because clearly somebody maliciously and trifling ass motherfucker chained the door from the inside so she couldn't get out, and they found gasoline empty containers inside of the car. Now, who burnt this car and burnt this girl to death? Well, her father. Her biological father burned the girl to death. And, you know, initially what I believe is that he was going to take his life and his child's life due to him and his ex-wife or ex-girlfriend or baby mama or whatever having, like, custody issues and, you know, stuff like that going on. So, you know, with whatever demons he was going through and whatever, you know, trauma this man was facing, you know, nobody knows what... Just to talk about... the demons that we all face for a second. Nobody knows what demons anybody is facing out here in this world. But we all, each and every one of us, are dealing with our own demons. And, you know, it is truly up to us to fight those demons and heal ourselves so we can live a better life, you know, and we can just live a better and greater life, and we can literally cross over once we heal ourselves and love ourselves unconditionally, regardless of our past situations, circumstances, or whatever. You can then cross over to the other side of this life, and the other side of this life is a life of abundance, resilience, and prosperity. So, you know, whatever demons this man was dealing with, you know, you know, say we don't know, he was going to, I believe, you know, this is not what was told in the media. They just said that he burned, I believe that he was going to take his life and his daughter's life. But I guess what happened was, in the midst of that, he thought things through, and whatever demons came upon him, he felt like, no, I'm just gonna take the most, I'm gonna take my child, you know, and I'm gonna hurt her mother to the core, instead of just hurting me and my daughter. So, you know, he got out the car, and when he got to the hospital, he was suffering from third degree burns all over his body. 70% of his body was burned. He jumped into a nearby pond or lake or whatever to cool himself off, you know, or whatever. So, you know, this is just so, the whole situation is so sad, you know. Him taking his daughter's life, that three, can you imagine the pain that she was going through physically, mentally, emotionally, you know, not even being able to fathom it all because she's three. She's a fucking baby, you know. And, you know, I'm pretty sure, man, she was in excruciating pain, crying, screaming, kicking, yelling until, you know, she took her last breath. I mean, this situation... It's so unfortunate for the mother of that child, and for the child who lost her life, and for that father. You know, so just to, before I go even deeper, that happened 2 weeks ago when everything was on the news and everything was, you know, we found out about everything. So last week, this week that just passed, they said that he was charged with murder because clearly he maliciously did this. He is a sick individual. He is a demonic soul. He is evil. You know, he is trifling. He is just sick. You know, just really sick to even have a thought to hurt your baby. You know, you created her, you know. But now I want to talk about, you know, really what the truth is of this situation. The truth of this situation is, if you are woke and you can literally see past the whole situation and look deep within, you know, and kind of like look deep within and look past it all at the same time, you can realize that not only was this man suffering with demons within himself, and he didn't know how to handle it, and he was a very sick individual to want to hurt your child, and then to physically take action upon that thought is sick. You know, it is a mental illness. It is demonic, and you know, it is literally your demons taking over you. Now, we know the child, yes, may Allah I know he's already doing what he is here to do, you know, here on the physical life and on the, and in our afterlives. I know that she is okay, and she is beautiful, smiling, laughing, and living her beautiful all afterlife. But you know, let's just take a minute to realize that if we don't heal the demons that we know we are suffering from and we have, then we are literally going to pass these demons on to our offsprings. And we are literally going to pass these demons to the people we surround ourselves with and the energy that we come in contact with. You know, you have to understand that, you know, none of us are perfect here, my babies. We literally all have struggles, issues, and demons. But you have to realize that you have to do the work. You know, you have to do the work on your life. You have to heal yourself. Some way, somehow, you have to figure your life out. And, you know, you have to learn and grow and evolve and love yourself. You know, this world is just truly missing love, and not just any kind of love, but unconditional love. We are judging one another. You know, we are following the wrong idols. You know, we are hurting, we are suffering, and we are afraid to live in our truth. You know, we feel like we don't want to heal ourselves and, you know, assess our demons and then heal ourselves from them because it's hard work. Well, guess what? This life in general is hard work. Like, literally. And you have to be strong enough and prepared, ready, willing, and able to do what you came here to do. You know, and it just really sucks, like, that people are so weak-minded and people are just, they don't have the capacity. They don't have the capacity to deal with their life, you know, and literally their life, which means your issues that you were born to, issues you probably walked into, and now you're stuck in a rut full of mud, and you're afraid to figure it out and get yourself out of that. But I'm telling you, my babies, it's possible. It's possible. Like, you can do it. It's nobody ever said that, you know, this life would be easy. You know, actually, everything that I hear and I see is it's hard work. You need determination, motivation, and straight focusedness to get yourself through the trials and tribulations, to get through to your triumphs, you know, and really see yourself through everything you thought you couldn't get through. You know, you have to understand that, yes, Allah really created this beautiful world. You know, like, literally, this earth, this life is beautiful. But what fucks up this life and this earth is people, places, and things that are full of demonic energy, you know, evilness, sickness, trifling, maliciousness, you know, negativity, BS, and drama. You have to understand that. And if you can't understand that, you will be sucked into it. And then you will be crying because you don't know, how did I end up here? How am I in this situation? How am I going to get myself up out of this? But only you create your life. You know, yes, our childhood, you know, a lot of things, our parents and our guardians and whoever raised us, they didn't know any better. So yes, they fucked us up in our childhood. But once you become an adult and you are still walking into traps and you're still hanging out with the wrong people, going to the wrong places, and, you know, just affiliating yourself with the wrong things, it is then your fault. You know, and you know, it's, you really have to, I only got a minute left. You really just have to watch your energy, my babies, because there is so many evil spirits and demonic souls and people that love negativity, BS, and drama in their lives. So they then surround themselves with you, who is trying to do better and, you know, uplift yourself and your life for the sake of your future and your soul. And then they suck your great energy from you, and they put all that bad toxicity within you. You have to understand that. So, you know, prayers up for, you know, the young girl, and God rest her soul, and prayers up for the girl's mom. I couldn't imagine going through any of that situation, you know, so I want to send condolences to her. Literally, just watch your energy. Watch the places you go, the things you do, and the people you affiliate yourself with. Thank you all for watching. I love you all so much, and I see you all in my next video.